times you make a mistake once in your life, you never have a chance to make a second one. You will die. It's the same with some of these epidemics. We lost Dr. Rukia in the north from Ebola. So when we are begging people, please be careful. We are not only begging you to be careful for the sake of your own life, but for the sake of others who are innocent. Doctors, we are trying to deal with the normal cases, you know, giving birth, treating malaria. Now, when you have got something so dangerous, it is really the duty of everybody. When I see people who are playing around, I really don't get amused. I don't have a good opinion of such people. Because you are not only endangering yourself, you are endangering others. So out of this 1,072 who became positive, 958 have been healed and have been discharged. The ones still in medical care are 114 as of yesterday. I therefore, and we also had foreigners who were coming here who were positive, especially the drivers, 1,369. But these were returned to their countries. But there are some who were treated here and they recovered, and these were 137. And we have had no death, not a single death. I therefore congratulate you, the people of Uganda. This is a remarkable achievement for which I'm very happy. Praise be the Lord God, and congratulations to Ugandans for fighting this war. In the fight, we were science-led. We were led by science. Science means understanding the nature well. That's what science is about. So when our scientists analyzed this disease, we could see where the danger was and where the opportunity was. And that's what guided us. Now, we had this virus, but we had also to support life. We could not say because of the virus, we abandoned all activities, because those activities are the ones which support us. The question, however, was, what social, economic, and spiritual activities can we safely undertake? That was the question. Which activities, economic ones, social ones, spiritual ones, can we undertake safely? On the one hand, we need to do activities that we normally do, but which ones of them can we do safely? At the same time, avoid this sickness. Fortunately, since this virus mainly spreads, like many viruses do, where there is overcrowding. I told you that before the Europeans came, our ancestors defeated smallpox, Omuse, by the same methods. The last smallpox epidemic was in 1893, before the Europeans came here. But our people defeated it by the some of the measures that we are telling you today. And those ones include avoiding crowding. Because when you crowd, you make the disease spread faster. So therefore, we looked at the activities. Which activities that do not involve crowding? Fortunately, we had agriculture. Agriculture, our type of agriculture especially, is in the homesteads. The homesteads are scattered. Each family is by itself. Whether you are in crops, or in livestock, or in fishing, you are spread across the country. So we said agriculture should continue because doesn't have much risk from this disease. But don't come to the towns, you just stay where you are. Then we said, even the factories could continue. That time we said, provided the workers stay camp near the factory. That's what we started with. But later on we relaxed that because we knew that the factory people are known. There are 200, you know them. Museveni, Rugunda, they are always working here. Even when they go home, you know where they stay. As long as they don't go to bars and so on, they go from work to home, you can easily trace them, even if there is some of them are infected, you can trace who they are because they are known. You know them here, where they are working. Maybe you know how they are going home. You know the people they have at home. It is easy to follow them up. So we said the factories. Later on, factory workers can go home, come and work and go home because they are traceable. The people on the construction sites who are constructing things, we said those could continue. Then on the food markets, the markets, we separated them. We said in this type of crisis, what you need most is food. As long as food is there, other things can come later. So let's make sure there is food. So the food markets should remain open. But other people who are not food sellers, please get out of the market. Because without separating the food sellers and the non-food sellers, you could not ensure the social distancing, the one we talked about. You could not say to Sembrera, when you have got people who are selling food, the ones who are selling the epikoi, the ones who are selling the, selling cattle, things that have nothing to do with food. So we said, no, the market should only remain for food. Other people stay out. Then on the services side, we said, hospitals must remain open. Of course, security forces and so on, a number of what we call essential services should remain open. Then on the social side, we said the marriages should continue, but should continue scientifically means you just bring people who are necessary in the marriage. Recently, I married off one of my children, and I chased off all the irrelevant people because we were conducting the illegal operation, and the leader of the illegal operation was Archbishop Kazimba with the two priests. Those were three. On my side, we were nine. including Mama and seven others. On the other side, there were seven. The whole of ceremony went on legally and spiritually, and the only thing we missed was the crowd, which normally comes on the on our usual weddings. That's the only thing we missed. But spiritually and legally, everything was perfect. My that daughter of mine is now legally and spiritually married. And go on. This was the other weekend. So we said the social didn't be scientific. Scientific means just bring the necessary people. The barriers the same. That's what we said. Then cargo transport. Cargo transport also was very crucial. You remember there was a debate about that. Some people even wanted to stop the cargo. I said, no, this one is so vital. There's no way you can stop cargo. So that's what we did that time. We said, this one, the rest, halt, suspend, but this must continue. Now, later on, after careful study, we added passenger vehicles. After some weeks, we added passenger vehicles, provided they observed what we called SOPs, standard operational procedures. Don't have full load, don't do this, don't do that. And public transport resumed. Then we also resumed restaurants and hotels were allowed to operate, provided they observed the SOPs. Then shops also. Shops, the standalone shops, but also the shopping malls were allowed to operate, provided they follow the SOPs. Now, because of that, that's why we are where we are. After 4 months of enemy attack, only 1,072 people were infected, and more than 900 of them have been healed and gone away, and nobody has died. Now, it seems some people are not happy with this.
You are right.
They are saying, why Ugandans not die?
Yes, they are saying, why? As if it is a crime.
They are not happy.
Why? Is it a crime? So, people not
they come
die?
With all sorts of untested ideas. This one. But it's no problem. Any activity can take place, provided
something foolish.
It can be done safely. That's the issue. It's not anything else. It's not that we have got fit enough against anybody, or we are careless. No. Only that we don't want you to kill our people.
Yes.
Because you are looking for money. Mm. Money. At the beginning, we said, please, all these things are important. Money is important, business is important, but life is number one.
Yes.
Anything that threatens life, we are not going to accept. We are not going to accept.
You are right there.
So that's why everything we do, I involve the scientists, our scientists. Fortunately, you are lucky, you have got very good scientists. this education, which we started was actually started by the British. But when we came, we ballooned it. It became so big, so many universities. You have got very good people, very good scientists. And that's why I would like you to agree to my idea of paying them well, instead of paying the storytellers. You should pay the scientists well. But people don't always accept my ideas. I'm always fighting as if I'm fighting to weed my garden or what. Always begging this one, begging that one, begging that one. But scientists will be paid. Well, these scientists can do a lot.
Sometimes you will miss this country. Sometimes you will miss it, but they don't understand.
After these people, whenever anything comes, you study it because they are there. But I'm beginning to hear some people attacking scientists. You can go to hell if you attack our scientists. I will tell you to go to hell because you are an enemy of our country. And we're not going to, we have fought many wars, we shall fight also with you. These are people who are looking for nothing. They just use their knowledge to say, this one is this, this one is, why should anybody be hostile to them? Why? In the, one of the early centuries, 15-something-something, there was a pope, His Holiness the Pope. I don't remember his name. You can go and look for it on the internet. There was a scientist called Galileo. In the past, people used to think that the earth was flat. They didn't know. They thought it was like a table. But this scientist, I don't know how he studied it, Galileo. He said, no, the earth is not round, it is not flat, it is round. And I think he even pointed out that it is the sun, the earth which is going around the sun. But this Pope, I think even hanged Galileo. Oh, imagine. The man who was right was hanged by an ignorant pope. So, humility by people is very, very important. If you can't want to survive, listen to the people who know. And these scientists happen to know some of these things of science. So therefore, after we had resolved the other issues, the ones I've mentioned, I said, now you study the others. There's been the issue of the Arcades. And of course, you people also should, when you have got Bapakasi, if you have got porters, you should always remember that don't give them too much law, too much work. So these scientists, I don't give them too much work. I give them some work. We study this first. And once they have done it well and finished, then we will move. So after we have finished the other activity, the ones that I talked about, like the restaurants, the shopping malls, then I said, you study these others. They have now come with their conclusions. They studied the arcades. Now, these arcades, They found out a lot of problems. First of all, they are enclosed. Secondly, they have got corridors between, I don't know, between what and what, between, I think, different subunits. Those corridors are called the Bikubo. Now, you had people sitting in the Bikubo, in the corridors, people were sitting there. You had people, too many people sitting inside one shop, sitting on the veranda, sitting on the steps, sitting on the roadsides, in front of the of these arcades. So these scientists have now studied this and produced a report. And we have now decided, on the advice of the scientists, that we can open these arcades. Some of the arcades, not all, provided they have the following. Number one, temperature guns. These are things which measure people's whether you have got a fever. Social distancing. To assembly must be observed. Hand washing. No traders, no people in the corridors in the Bikubo. No people there. The corridor is a corridor, it's not a shop, it's not. No traders on the verandas. No traders on the steps or the roadsides. They must also keep records. Everybody who buys there must be recorded. Yoweri Museveni, ID card number this, of Ruachitura, or Nakasero, whichever you address you want. Why do we need this record must be in the book. And why do we need the record? In case you get sick, you, the shop fellow, the shop seller, we need to know which people you have interacted with so that we can follow them up. That's why we need a record. The shoppers also must social distance. The sellers, social distance. Inside, abakora mu dukezo, but you know, we no question. Question is, this is the Nyankore one for being apart. But also the shoppers who are coming to shop, they must have social distance. They don't come to, no. You arrange them, they come. No air conditioning. No air conditioning. Because air conditioning is what causes problems in Europe and the US, that they advanced. That advancement that does not respect nature is part of the problem. I never use air conditioning. There's air conditioning in your government house in Entebbe. I switched it off long ago. So that air conditioning is very dangerous because it is the one which is saturating the virus. Everybody must put on masks. Everybody, the shop assistants, the shoppers, must all put on masks. Enough toilets. enough toilets. If you have got an acute which does not have enough toilets, we shall close it permanently. Because there's no reason why you should create a disease causing unit in the town here. If you are looking for money, then look for the for money safely. And I don't know how whether they resolve even the issue of paying for going to the toilet. I don't know whether that has come up, because that was a big issue at one time. Now, apparently, in Kampala, there have been 230 arcades. Well, these arcades, I wanted to find out what they sell. What do these arcades sell? Whose products do they sell? I was told at one time they were selling Chinese products. That's their job. Their job was to make us a market of China. Those are arcades. And Kasita group, Kasita, this sector. Their job, their historical mission, is to make that sure that Uganda is a market of China, the market of India, the market of Dubai. And we have been advising, I even called them to enter. I said, please, you people. It's really amazing because Chinese, when you go to, I was somewhere in the industrial area recently, Namahave. The other time I was in Kapeka. And the Chinese in Kapeka told me, we started importing ceramic tiles here. And we saw there was a big market, so we decided to make the factory of ceramic markets here. The Chinese, when he imports 1 year, 2 years, and he sees there is a good market, he builds the factory here. And that was what I saw. The other day I was also visiting another factory in Namahave of Chinese. The same idea that there was, I think there was bringing, I don't remember what, the one I visited last, bringing some, once they saw the market was there, they built a factory here. Now, these arcades fellows have been Osaka from China for 30 years to buy from China, never thinking of building a factory here. There's a problem there. There's a problem there. We cannot go on being a market of other people. So these arcades should shift and sell our products. I don't mind if they are selling our products. Products made here. Because those products, when it is made here, it creates jobs for your children. In South Africa, our pocket support now the jobs of Chinese. When you buy Chinese products, you are supporting jobs for the Chinese children in China. And then you are crying here that our people have no jobs. So although we are opening these arcades, and the other ones, the shopping malls and all that, please start working to produce many of the products you are selling. If you know that there's a market, a big market here, then produce those products here. There was a man called Kashwada of Ujiru. It used to be called Ujiru, a Chinese man, a Japanese. You can imagine this man, Kashwada. He came here first time in 1955. He
a speech, a kumala, guala, or can't come. That speech, a kumala, ukumanye kumanya, chigenda mass, wavering you.